They say the new director can match objects up to 20 feet.
Bullshit. We've never recorded any distance over.
Obviously, you never read it.
Jesse, you made it. And you lifted the internal lockdown.
Let's talk, Emily. Listen, Emily. Screw it. Just tell her. I haven't been completely honest. I have a younger brother, Dylan. When we were kids, we found an old slide projector in Ordinary's landfill. The slides created doorways to other places. Bad things happened. Came through. That's all she gets. The rest stays locked inside. But we found help. Through one of the doorways, we met something. A being.
A being? What kind of being?
It's hard to describe, but it... She helped us. We managed to turn the projector off. The bad things that came through the doorways were gone. After that, your people came. Tried to grab us. I ran away. They got Dylan.
I left him behind.
Bureau agents took your brother?
Yes. You covered it up. No one believed me. I just want to find Dylan. I've been looking for him ever since.
What happened to the slide projector? It sounds like another object of power.
I thought you took it. The Bureau. Along with Dylan.
I've never heard of it. But around here, I assume everything's classified. You know, I looked into the Ordinary AWE case files after you mentioned it. Trench and Darling were both involved. A large area of the containment sector was reserved for it. The case hasn't been active for a long time. I have no idea if anything's still there. Can you tell me more about this being you found?
Let's hope you two get along. She's been with me ever since Ordinary. In my head. She led me to you. I call her Polaris.
As in, a guiding star. Did Polaris know about the hiss? If she got you in here, in spite of the lockdown, she's very powerful. Which may help explain your test results. Your readings are incredible, Jesse. Now, cross-referencing them with the database, I found two matches in Darling's old classified files. Unfortunately, I can't access them beyond the file codes, but one was P6, referring to a prime candidate for a potential future bureau director. This was logged years ago.
Dylan. Is that Dylan?
The other match is on something called Hedron, which must be connected to these Hedron Resonance amplifiers somehow. All I know is that Marshall went to the research sector to secure the HRA production after the Hiss first attacked.
So... Marshall seems like our best lead on Dylan. I need to go after her. How can I get to the research sector?
Use my key card. The sector elevator will take you there.
Marshall is the next step. What Emily told me about Ordinary, my powers being connected to things in the Bureau's past, I am so close to something. Do you feel it? Something's coming.
We take turns to come for a visit. I helped you. You owe me now. And when time comes, I will come calling.
I heard that this attacked the power plant. Brings up a lot of new questions. Are they communicating? Coordinating? What about the plant attracted them?
The power... Our plan is largely confidential. No use guessing the Hiss's motives if we don't even know what kind of...
These questions could be answered by a live specimen.
Hi, Jesse. I keep finding traces of Darling, but still can't find him. Where could he be?
He's usually in his office in research, or one of his labs. Dr. Darling has quite a few, all around the Bureau. Could be hiding in any one of them. I'd check myself, but I don't have access to most of them.
Sounds like I touched a nerve.
He didn't let you into his labs?
Not all of them, no. Some had volatile material. That's ridiculous. I mean, this whole place is volatile material. Could have at least thought of a more convincing lie. I mean, how can I work without access to all the data possible?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you notice the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of Bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark, Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you notice the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of Bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark, Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
On the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid. The board, all linked, intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director, the process of choosing a director, tied to all objects of power in terms of who controls them. Yes.
You are
was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then, one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions, apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement, native species, always in the distance, and yet, contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astronauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
I can't believe they keep that thing here.
Doing with that thing?
Someone answer, damn it! We need backup down here!
Marshall, are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
Thank you.
here.
Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm setting the elevator for you. We need a talk.
She got that right.
More of you? Really?
Welcome to the party, ma'am. Marshall is right down the hall.
Thank you.
Marshall is waiting for you in the luck lab, just down the hall.
There you are. I was starting to worry. Congratulations on your appointment, Director Faden. I'm Helen Marshall, head of Bureau Operations. Zachariah's dead then, and I assume you found his gun.
Just call me Jesse. Trench told me to find you. He said you could help.
And he told you this through the hotline. Makes sense.
None of this fazes her? Really?
Here's the situation. Darling created the HRAs in a lab nearby. We need more if we're gonna survive this attack. My Rangers can't secure the lab alone, not against those things. We need more firepower.
At least she seems to know what's going on here. She could know about Dylan.
I can clear out the hiss. I'll be your firepower.
That's a good answer.
Is she testing me?
Darling has systems in place to protect his labs. This should help you get past them. We'll talk more after you clear out the hiss. Rangers, let her through. We'll have to lock the door behind you. Sorry, but we can't risk a breach.
Has anyone heard from Salvador?
Last anyone heard, he was taking a security team in the container. The reason is currently unknown.
I think I know the reason.
I see the Rangers over there. We have to help them.
Thank you.
Charts. As if you can find anything in this place.
Fire!
situation?
Squad C hasn't made it back. They're still out there. We should see them again. Only exit is back to the Kirkland Scholarship. There's no way we're making it left.
Engaging! Altered item number 52AE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the item. First, a low voltage electric shock. No response. Next, I will introduce heat via a standard Bunsen burner. No response. Next, a series of solutions will be applied, each with a different value on the pH scale, from 0 to 14. No response to any value. Next, I will attempt to communicate. Can you understand me? Can you understand my words? Quack, if you can understand my words. No response. This concludes session 2. We'll need time to prepare further tests.
This way to the lab? Okay. You must like these HRAs. Sounds like Darling built them. And most of the things around here. If Marshall can't help us with Dylan, he's our next best bet. Assuming he's not dead. Or taken over by the Hiss. Me here. Any idea how to make it work?
Hello again, Director. It appears we have a new problem. We need to get the HRA machine working.
I've replaced a couple of spark plugs, but this looks a bit more complicated.
Darling must have had a system. Randomness isn't in his nature. The punch cards, the symbols, the terminals. How do they connect?
I'll see what I can do.
We need to find all the punch cards. Each punch card should correspond to a terminal. These whiteboard drawings may be important. It looks like he was working on something to do with these symbols. What do the symbols mean? What do these whiteboards mean? Try different combinations. One of them has to work.
Thank you.
The prism shattered. Darling's prototypes have a lot of issues. We need a new plan. We need more Blackrock prisms to make this machine work. Darling has another lab, down in the Blackrock processing site and maintenance. That must be where he keeps the prisms.
I've been to maintenance already. I can find my way.
But how long will that take? Nothing here is simple. I need to ask her now, before I go.
I need something from you first. What do you know about Dylan Faden?
I knew this was coming. Lives are at stake here, and we need this machine working to save those lives. Once that is done, Director Faden, then we can talk.
She's right. As much as I don't want to admit it, I'm the only one who can help.
Fine. I'll get the prisms first.
Dylan, we'll have to wait just a little longer.
But don't call me Director. Jesse is fine.
I'll call you Faden. Here, you'll need this keycard.
Thanks. Emily Pope has set up a base in Executive. Once I have the prism, I'll meet you there.
Right. I'll move out immediately. And keep an eye out for Darling. Finding him might be the key to stopping the hiss.
It's just one large scale HRA. It's there now. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedron resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedron can provide us, and keeping us from being wiped out.
Here, this will lead back to Central Research.
Followed you in, right? Pope wants us to compile all of Darling's data entries from the past month.
She wants us to crack Darling. Personal locks? He'll crucify us if he finds out. She thinks she is authorizing that kind of data breach.
She must think he's hiding something. And I agree. The HRA's alone. Darling knew more than he let.